It's not every day that I purchase a game at launch, but after seeing the trailers for Resident Evil Village and knowing how much I enjoyed Resident Evil 7, I really wanted to play this game. So the day after Resident Evil Village released, I went to my local GameStop and picked it up for the Xbox at its full $60 price tag, which I really wasn't thrilled about. But it was one of those games I just had to play. I got it home, installed it to my Xbox, and was all ready to play. And of course, I got distracted and forgot all about it. About a week ago, I was looking for a new game to review for the channel, and I found Resident Evil tucked away on a shelf. And this time, I did not give myself a chance to get distracted. I popped it into my Xbox and got to playing. So now that I have had a chance to play through the game, it's time to answer the question, what's it worth? Hello everyone, and welcome back to another episode of What's It Worth, where I review a game, show a little gameplay, and give an idea of what a game is worth. So make sure that you subscribe to the channel for more What's It Worth reviews. Please note, I understand a game is worth what someone is willing to pay for it. Obviously, anyone is able to have their own opinion on what they like and dislike and have the freedom to buy and pay whatever they feel is reasonable. This is just my opinion based on the content within a game, the age of a game, how long it is, replayability, and if there is a multiplayer available and how good that multiplayer is. I have spent many years buying and playing games and have a general idea of what I feel I should be paying. This is simply to give you an idea or baseline of what a game is worth. And if money is no object, this is still a general review, so there is still something here for you. So let's get started. I had gotten my start in the Resident Evil series with Resident Evil 4 for the PlayStation 2. Since then, I have enjoyed the series for the most part. I loved Resident Evil 4, 5, and 7, and even liked Operation Raccoon City. I have not yet gotten around to playing Resident Evil 2 or 3, the remakes, and the only Resident Evil that I have played in recent memory that I didn't much care for was Resident Evil 6. So needless to say, I had high hopes for Resident Evil Village. Resident Evil Village is set a few years after the events that transpired in Resident Evil 7 Biohazard. If you have not yet played Resident Evil 7, which I highly recommend doing because it is a great game, you will be able to watch a video that will summarize the story from Resident Evil 7 to get you caught up to current events. You are once again playing as Ethan Winters, who is the protagonist from Resident Evil 7. To summarize the story without giving away too many spoilers, Ethan and his wife Mia have started a new life together and have had a child named Rose. Shortly into the story, Rose is kidnapped and Ethan will inevitably find himself in a village battling horrifying creatures to get his daughter back. As you progress through the story, you will learn that the main antagonist, Miranda, who is responsible for research on a type of mold that can grant superhuman abilities and for conducting experiments on the villagers, that ultimately causes the lichen or canine type creatures that you battle throughout the story. The story has a variety of twists and turns that makes the story engrossing to say the least. I found myself reading every letter or note I could find to gain more knowledge about the story and the possible events to come. The story took me approximately 9.5 hours to complete. This game simply looks amazing. The character models and enemies look absolutely fantastic, and the game does a great job of capturing the detail and essence of your eerie surroundings. I did not notice any slowdowns or graphical issues on Xbox, however, depending on your system, your mileage may vary. Resident Evil Village's gameplay does a spectacular job in reminding you that you are playing a survival horror game and not just a shooter. The game will often leave you with less ammo than needed for enemies, which will have you scavenging for more ammo and trying not to get torn apart and eaten. There is plenty of spooky areas where I found myself taking time to examine different things in the environment because of all the detail and thought put into it. The game has jump scares and some are so painfully obvious that they are coming, yet they still got me. I do have to say, nothing gave me more chills in this game than trying to find different items and keys to unlock doors, and having Lady Dimascu following me around and trying to murder me, Wolverine style. The game does have its fair share of puzzles, and I found them enjoyable. They weren't too difficult, and they just elevated the experience. There are several different guns and options to upgrade them throughout the game, and the gunplay, while slow, is fun and expected if you've played some of the other Resident Evil games. There is another game mode in addition to the story that is unlocked after completion of the game. It is called Mercenaries, which was a mode from Resident Evil 5, and this mode consists of a stage with enemies to defeat in an allotted time frame to get a score or a rank. I played this and had some fun playing around with it, and I am quite happy that it's a free addition to the game. Even though it is not something I would spend every waking moment on, it's still nice to see it as a bonus. This game does offer some replayability. The game has higher difficulties and the ability to play the higher difficulties either as a new game or with all of the equipment you had in the first playthrough. After the completion of the game, the bonus menu will open and offer completion points, which are gotten from tasks that can be completed in the story of the game and used in the bonus menu to unlock new weapons, skins, and gallery items. I did purchase the game new, and it did come with a code for Resident Evil Reverse, which looks to be a standalone, but also came with Resident Evil Village. Although, when I attempted to play it, it said that the servers weren't available. So I don't know if it's my Xbox or Xbox Live, or if it isn't out yet, since Capcom's website does say that it's not coming out till summer of 2021. So that being said, I am not sure when this is going to be playable, so there's not really much more I can say about it. I had a blast with Resident Evil Village. I love the story and how everything was put together. I enjoyed every moment of the 9.5 hours I spent in the story, and I enjoyed Mercenaries for the time I spent with that as well. I really only have two gripes. One is the game is rather short. The other is that the multiplayer Reverse has a code included with the game, and I wasn't even able to play it, at least on my Xbox. So what's it worth? This game is definitely an enjoyable experience. It has a decent reason to return in regards to replayability for possible future playthroughs, and has some decent post-game content. So if you were looking to pick up this game, I would definitely say this game is worth around the $40 mark. As always, I hope this helps. If you enjoyed this review, make sure you drop a like on it and subscribe for more What's It Worth content. Thank you so much. Later.